Everyone, Jason Schabert here of MzeroA.com alongside John making his video debut. John's normally behind the scenes making all the magic happen. He's our director of video production here at MzeroA.com. Been with us a very long time. You've met him at many air shows, I'm sure of it. We got ourselves in a bit of a jam here. We are out doing some great online ground school videos. We landed at X-ray 60. It's kind of become an overcast layer, a broken layer, kind of working its way on in with this cold front here. And we now need to depart IFR. Williston is a pilot-controlled airport. How do we get our IFR clearance out of a pilot-controlled airport? There's a few ways to do it, really three ways to do it. You can call an RCO, remote communications outlet, a GCO, ground communications outlet, if the airport has these facilities available, or you can call the LEIDOS IFR clearance delivery line as well. You can give them a ring as well. So we have all that set up. We've got our numbers all set up. We're going to go ahead and make that phone call now and grab our IFR clearance on the phone on the ground, and then we'll go ahead and depart here.
Final low approach, only
step down just a bit
Willis
while we make that phone call. Morning, this is Jason Schabert and 23 Mike Zulu. I'm number one for 32 at X60, ready for departure and IFR clearance.
Stand by. We're 23 Mike Zulu. You're cleared to the Ocala Airport as filed. When you're in controlled airspace, fly heading 170. Climb maintain 3000. Departure frequency is 118.6. Squawk 4233.
All right, so cleared to Ocala. 170 on departure up to 3000. 118.6. 4233 is our squawk.
23 Mike Zulu, Rebecca is correct, and you're void if not off in 5 minutes.
All right, void if not off in 5 minutes, and we'll call you on 18-6 then. Thank you for your help.
Thank you. Have a good flight.
See ya. All right, perfect. So we got that. We'll put the phone away. Run-up is already complete. I'm just going to get my door shut. Done letting that Florida air conditioning in. Remember to turn up the frequency you're on, though, because you weren't listening to it for a bit because you're on the phone. So we'll listen to that and watch for just a bit here. Our run-up is already complete. Everything is set. I'm looking down 3-2. I don't see anybody. Looking at the base of 3-2. I don't see anybody.
Williston traffic, TBM short final 2-3 low approach on LA Williston.
Well, that's why we don't see anybody. We're holding short 3-2, and TBM's on short final for 2-3. So we'll wait just a second. And Williston traffic, 2-3 Mike Zulu's holding short of 3-2 for that TBM traffic. Then we'll depart at Williston. Everything is set. I've got Ocala set. I'm going to go ahead and bug my heading out of here, which he wanted a 170. Bug my altitude as well, which is up to 3,000 feet. All of that is set. All of that looks good. We'll let that TBM announce he's clear. 18.6 is my next frequency. My transponder squawk code is in. You've seen the videos before. You know it's all about thinking ahead of this airplane, doing everything we can.
We'll ascend TBMs on the mist, climbing through 1,000 feet. Straight out, runway 23, Williston.
All right, he's on the mist. He's down there. We'll go ahead and depart. And Williston traffic, Skyhawk 23, Mike Zulu's departing runway 32 at Williston. He's already up and out at 1,000 feet. We'll go ahead and depart. All right, looks good. Heels at the floor, toes to bottom pedal, smoothly applying some full power. Engine gauges green, green, green. Airspeed is alive. Whew, good little wind there.
Well, traffic, we're 1 mile south of the airport, climbing out of 2,500, continuing south, Williston.
He's continuing out to the south, we'll be out to the south as well, but I'd argue a TBM's a little faster than us today. We're looking great, just watch that crossing runway as we come across it, looks clear. And he wants us on a 170, out of here. Make it all the way to the downwind. We'll make a downwind departure. Then I'll show you another great trick a very smart controller shared with me. Wilson traffic, 23 Mike Zulu's turning left, crosswind, runway 32 will be departing the area to the south. Wilson traffic. We'll turn this cross. What that controller taught me is when I contact Jack's approach, or the approach controller at this point, when I call them up and report that I'm just off of Williston, to go ahead and call them and tell them, you know, give them an ident as well, because they're gonna ask for the ident anyways here. I'll make this downwind departure here. We're just about to enter controlled airspace, so I'll give them a call. Wilson traffic, 23 Mike Zulu is turning left downwind, runway 32, departing the area on the downwind, Williston. Because here comes my 170 over to Jack's approach.
A little bit south of Victor 441. Clear to ignition intersection, join Victor 441. What is the?
I got my hand ready on the ident button to give him that ident in a second.
November India India Tango Sierra. Yes, sir. November India Tango Tango Sierra.
Tough to spell those fixes, huh?
November India Tango Tango Sierra. Radio Romeo. Sir, flying 245 when able to clear ignition. Fly heading on 245 and then get a direct net. 88 Romeo.
Afternoon, Jack. Skyhawk 23, Mike Zulu just off X60, 170 on the heading, 1200, climbing 3000.
Number 23, Mike Zulu, Jack's approach, air radar contact, 1 mile southwest of Wilson Airport. Advise when you get its mission Delta for Ocala. Check the ILS runway 36.
We'll advise Delta and expect the ILS for 36 Ocala. Thank you, 23, Mike Zulu. So you notice how I gave that ident right away. We were radar contact on the next radio call. It wasn't radio call to radio call, trying to identify all of that. 170, I need to grab the weather now at Ocala was the next thing he asked for. Which will keep on climbing up here.
Jacksonville, Seneca, 2845 Alpha, with you level 5000.
Got traffic.
And 7 Golf with 30 is traffic at your 12 o'clock, 3 miles westbound, altitude increase 1,400.
We'll look at 7 Golf with
30. Here's our weather.
And number 23 Mike Zulu, maintain 3,000 and confirming to be ILS full stop 36.
Maintain 3,000, yes, that ILS 36 will be a full stop, 23 Mike Zulu.
Next to 449, I got your check on, thank you.
Use caution for a crane.
Hey, Romeo, contact Tampa approach on 125.3, good day. 125.3, 8
This is the ADIS and him simultaneously.
Echo, do you have information? Echo.
Echo now. Listen.
Ocala Airport.
Echo, Seneca 284 for level 5,000.
New weather.
Seneca 284 out, 2845
out, the ceiling 1,500.
Just confirm you're on the ILS 36, right?
212.117, altimeter 3,001. Landing and departing runway 36. The ILS 36 approach in use. No service.
Great. Got echo. Altimeter's all the same. Everything looks good. Jack's 23 Mike Zulu has echo at Ocala.
Number 22 Mike Zulu, roger. Number 7 Golf Hotel, Travis heading eastbound on 05 to contact the Cal Tower 190.25. I'll see you in the go.
225, 7 Golf Hotel.
Looking great.
Altitude.
Altitude's coming up here. All's looking great. Let the autopilot now do some work.
3 Mike Zulu, turn 10 degrees left.
10 left for 3 Mike Zulu. Beauty of having that heading bug and everything else ready to go. That wind's really blowing us a lot here. So let it turn us over 10 left here. And we already cleared land. You can see we've got a direct crosswind over there from the left. I'm going to keep just my 10 degrees of flaps in. Not a big deal. It's very, very windy. It's probably the right call anyways here. Plus, we like landing long because we have a very long taxi. And we'll just hold it off. Hold it off. Put that upwind wheel down first. Looking down that runway. Hold it off. Hold it off. And just let it roll, save those brakes. No need to eat up those brakes. And clear.
That's 3 Mike Zulu, same tensions.
Back to the North Sea hangars, please.
You want to go all the way to Alpha 1 or Alpha 3?
I'll hop off at Alpha 3 for you.
Turn right, Alpha 3, you can taxi to the T-Airs.
Alpha 3, T-Airs with you. Thank you, TD Mike Zulu. So there you have it. How do we get our clearance at a pilot-controlled airport? Always something different, always learning something new as well. Can't wait to read your comments below this video on Facebook, on YouTube, on MZeroA.com. Enjoy the rest of your day, and most importantly, remember that a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya.
I can just see there's going to be a ton of comments about how much of a chatterbox I am.
Yeah, I was literally thinking that.
I wrote the private pilot blueprint with the intention of, if I could do my flight training over, would I wish someone would have told me? And I want that book to be yours for free. All I ask is that you pay shipping. Visit privatepilotblueprint.com to get your free copy.